Dear students, welcome to online class. Today we are going to discuss about a lesson gravitation from 9th class physics. Let us discuss some natural things. We always observe that an object dropped from certain height always falls towards the earth. And also, all the planets move around the sun. Moon moves around the earth in a circular path. In all these cases, there must be some force acting on these objects to make them move around another object instead of moving in a straight path. You can see the images here. So we have basic questions here. What is the force that is making the thing which is revolving around the one object around the other object? So is the motion of earth around the sun is uniform, or is the motion of the moon around the earth is uniform? Newton explained the motion of the moon by using the concept of uniform circular motion. And then he developed the idea of gravitation between any two masses. So in this chapter, you will learn about gravitation and center of gravity. Let us discuss about uniform circular motion. So you are seeing three pictures. In the first picture, on the left hand side, a car is revolving around. A car is moving around a circular path continuously with a constant speed. In the middle picture, say a boy is making the stone rotate in a circular motion by applying some force. And in the right hand side picture, blades of the fan are rotating in a circular motion. Is speed is constant in each and every case? Yes. Is the time of revolution constant? Yes. What is the shape of its path? Definitely, the car, the stone, and the blade of the fan rotate in a circular path, taking the shape of circular path. So this type of motion is known as uniform circular motion. So coming to the definition, uniform circular motion is the motion of the body with a constant speed in a circular path. So now let us go with these questions. Does the velocity of the body change in uniform circular motion? Does the body in uniform circular motion have an acceleration? What is the direction of acceleration? Do remember, in the previous slide we have seen the speed is constant, hence we can call it as uniform motion. Now here asking velocity. So let us go with an activity. The aim of this activity is drawing velocity vectors for a body in uniform circular motion. Recall the motion path taken by the stone in the above activity. So draw the path of the stone and draw the velocity vectors at successive time intervals. So let us draw. Let us take a stone and it is rotating in circular path with constant speed. So now let us take a point there in a circular path. If you release the stone at that place, it will go in that direction. Hence we can say that the velocity is acting in that direction. Now that will become V. Let us take one more point on the circular path. If you release there, it will go in the arrow direction. Now, the velocity is acting in the direction. In the first case, it is acting towards the north, and in the second case, it is acting towards the west. Let us take one more point on the circular path. Then, the velocity is acting in the south direction. We can have one more point on the circular path. So now it is acting in east direction. See, by checking the velocity direction at four points, they will have different directions. That means velocity is continuously changing wherever we have taken the path. Now you can see the picture. The arrow marks represents the direction of velocity. Now, when there are n spots find, then they will become the circular polygon, a regular polygon. So you have seen the right hand side picture. Let a body move with a constant speed v in a circular path of radius r. The velocity vector changes direction and appears to rotate. At each and every point, the velocity direction changes. If a velocity vector is rotated through a small angle, the change in velocity delta v will be represented by the base of the isosceles triangle. Now we have seen here, the entire circular path is divided into 8 triangles and delta v will be the base of the each isosceles triangle. Now you can see the black triangle, and the two sides are represented by V and base is delta V, change in velocity. Let us consider the change in velocity during the course of a complete revolution of a body. So the sum of the magnitude of the changes in velocity during a complete revolution will be equal to the sum of the sides of a depicted polygon. Yes, but the direction of velocity is changing continuously. So the exact value of the sum of the magnitude of all the changes in velocity of a body during the course of revolution will be equal to the circumference, that is 2 pi r, but here r is v, so hence 2 pi v. We know that the magnitude of the acceleration is equal to the ratio of magnitude of change in velocity for one revolution and the time period. Let AC be the magnitude of acceleration of the body in uniform circular motion. Hence, acceleration is equal to velocity by time. So that is AC is equal to 2 pi v by t, where t is the time required to complete one revolution. We know that t is equal to 2 pi r by v. So substituting these expressions, finally we got acceleration in a circular path is equal to v square by r. As the vertex angle of isosceles triangle decreases, the angle between the change in velocity and velocity vector approaches to 90 degrees. Therefore, the acceleration of a body in uniform circular motion is directed perpendicular to its velocity. That is nothing but the tangent. But how are the velocity and acceleration directed relative to the path? Since the velocity is a tangent to the path and the acceleration is directed along the radius towards the center of the circle. So this acceleration that changes only the direction of velocity of a body is called centripetal acceleration. So this acceleration changes only direction, not the magnitude of the velocity. Newton's second law says that The net force on a moving body produces an acceleration in it which is directed along the net force. So, in uniform circular motion, a net force acts towards the center like acceleration. So, this net force is called centripetal force. The net force which changes only the direction of the velocity of a body is called centripetal force, like centripetal acceleration. So let us find the value of centripetal force. So let us have these things so that the tangents at the particular points are direction of velocity and the direction towards the center will be the acceleration. According to Newton's second law, F is equals to mass into acceleration, that is m into ac, substituting Fc is equals to mv square by r, so where r is the radius of the circle. In uniform circular motion, Fc always directs towards the center. And centripetal force is a net force directed towards the center of the circle.